I want to tell you about a few of the things that I have learned during these last 5 years of intensive research. Perhaps the most startling thing that I can share with you is that all of the conspiracy theories that you've ever heard about one world government, about the UN takeover of the world, all of those conspiracies have now been laid to rest. There's nothing conspiratorial about it. It's all published. The UN-funded Commission on Global Governance began meeting in 1992 in earnest and met for 4 years and last fall released their final report. It is entitled Our Global Neighborhood. A few of the things that they wish to do: create a world standing army under the day-to-day command of who else? The UN Secretary General. They recommend the creation of a new Economic Security Council, into which the World Bank, the International Monetary Fund, the United Nations Development Program, and the World Trade Organization would all be consolidated. A unified worldwide banking scheme, currency. I don't think I need to draw any more pictures on that point. Now, those non-government organizations like ours that are not accredited by the UN, we are called populist trash activists who can destroy, they say, in a moment, years of deliberation. And you're darn right. And I have been challenged on the radio and in audiences like this: Mr. Lamb, there's no such thing as a global agenda. Hey, friend, you're absolutely wrong. Here it is. It's called Agenda 21. Agenda 21. The primary document presented in Rio de Janeiro and adopted by more than 100 heads of state, including George Bush, which lays out in intricate detail all of the transformation that must take place in society in order for it to become sustainable as they define sustainability. This may be available at the United Nations bookstore. I had to pick this up. I had not seen one until last July, had not been able to get one. I happened to be in Geneva attending a United Nations meeting and went to the bookstore and bought the thing. I believe it cost $45. Now, the Conference of the Parties held its first meeting in Nassau last December. At that first meeting, the United Nations Environment Program presented them with a global biodiversity assessment. Started in 1992 with a grant from the Global Environment Facility for $3.3 million, orchestrated and coordinated by the World Resources Institute and the World Wildlife Fund and the International Union for the Conservation of Nature. This is 1,140 pages that explains how to implement the 16-page treaty on biodiversity. The last 200 pages, section 13, deals specifically with a system of protected areas. It defines what a system of protected areas is. It includes core wilderness areas surrounded by buffer zones, similar to those used in the biosphere reserves, created under a UNESCO program and promoted by the United States Man in the Biosphere program. There are 382 biosphere reserves around the world, 47 of which are in the United States, not under authority of any treaty, but by voluntary agreement with the United Nations. These biosphere reserves are to be the nucleus for the core wilderness areas. scratching my head here, what on earth is going on? And then I stumbled on page 993, and friends, if you don't think that's some heavy reading at night. Page 993, after describing these protected areas, sums it all up by saying, the recently published Wildlands Project in the United States is the central theme of protected areas. And on page 15 of the Wildlands Project, Dr. Reed Noss says that we must convert at least 50% of the land area of North America to wilderness, off limits to human beings. Those core wilderness areas are to be interconnected by wilderness corridors, off limits to human beings. Those wilderness areas are to be surrounded by buffer zones that may have limited resource use under the supervision and permitting of the federal government in collaboration with non-government organizations. Human population is to be resettled into the remaining 25% of the land into communities that are described as sustainable communities. Now let me put a parenthesis right here for a moment. He created what he called a White House Task Force on Ecosystem Management. He called 20 federal departments together and said, you will create an ecosystem management policy and you will implement the ecosystem management policy throughout the federal government, Department of Interior, Department of Agriculture, Department of Commerce, Department of Education, throughout the federal government. They developed what they called multimedia enforcement. Where they run into a problem with a community that will not accept this ecosystem management concept, multimedia enforcement means that all 20 federal agencies descend on the community and begin inspections and writing tickets. I couldn't believe it.
I see your element. You got about four Humvees out along this. You're clear.
All right, firing.
Line here. With the state line, let me know when you get them.
Or shoot.
Light them all up.
Come on, fire.
Now let's catch up with some other news from around the world. the United States, Seattle police are again under fire over allegations of violence, the second time in a matter of weeks. Video footage appeared to show a Seattle officer punching a teenage girl in the face after stopping her from jaywalking. That followed a case a few weeks before where police were caught beating an unarmed and innocent man. A scandal also erupted last year with an officer convicted of a vicious attack on a 15-year-old girl in a jail cell.
They did it to try and belittle me, to try to take away my pride. But I went through the whole system with them, and at the end, I wanted the public to know that I was okay, even though I was hurting.
What happened when they arrested you? What did they do to you?
They manhandled me very roughly. My shoulder is dislocated, literally. It's hurting me very badly. I'm in pain all the time. See this arm? This is as far as I can reach it. Same with this side over here.
Because of what happened at the police station?
Yeah, at the police station. And what they did to me, if you saw what they did to my arms, it was very bad what they did.
Joe Ellison out here on the Arkansas River in the Roseville community just south of Logan County. Take a look at these drunk fish. The Arkansas Game and Fish Commission say they have found 1,000 washed up on the bank.